What's up, fellow Sambarians? Today I'm here with the Green Dragon Spitfire Goober Chan here. I don't know if you saw that video. We took it out front to kind of just film the exhaust for my buddy Scott, just to kind of show him what it sounded like and all that stuff. And she was actually spitting fire out the muffler, which is just insane to think that that little tiny motor is just pushing out that much power out of that little tiny engine. Anyways, if you haven't seen it, it's on my YouTube shorts or Instagram. It's hilarious. Anyways, so today we're going to be doing rear speakers on the green Sambar Diaz. So I'll kind of show you what we got. So the rear cards, panel cards, whatever, there's actually an existing hole right here. If you've ever taken these off to clean them, this was used as a bird catching van or disposed of animals in Japan that weren't supposed to be there. So this van was pretty nasty when I got it from Larry, who had just imported it. So he hadn't even really done anything with it. Obviously he just got it and we picked it up from Larry, and it was pretty nasty inside. I mean, it was nasty, but I've gone through, cleaned it up, installed the carpet. Much better. This van has come a long way since the day we bought it from Larry up there in Ferndale at Import Guys. Anyways, these side panels, we're going to remove the old cards and install. We're gonna install. Kick. These guys. I feel like I'm blind. I can't see what I'm doing. So these cards are the same exact size that's in there, but they have Subaru speakers. So Subaru obviously had an option for rear speakers in your Diaz, and these are them. And the reason these actually came up in Yahoo auctions, and a guy in the Sambar squad pointed them out in Yahoo auctions, and I had to have them for Goober Chan because it was going to be perfect. But see, you need this bracket that mounts. I don't know if you necessarily need it. You could probably make your own setup. These door cards have seen better days. But I mean, these are Subaru speakers with the wire connections, and here we go. I was looking for the end. So I have not taken these apart yet. So obviously they ran those in the back as an option. So we're gonna find out if that wire is running in through the back, and if they are, we're just gonna splice right into the existing wire if it's running to the back. If it is not, that is okay, because guess what? I know it's kind of hard to decipher wiring when it comes to the radio, figuring out which one does what and all that, because there's so many wires that go into the radio. Since we have the speakers and the existing wiring, we know what colors we're looking for. So obviously we got gray, and we have gray with the black stripe for our rear speaker, and the other one is like a pink and a violet and a violet black stripe. So I'm guessing black stripe is negative, but yes, black stripe is negative according to the posts. So that's okay. If there is no wiring running to the back, we can wire our own, because we have an aftermarket radio in there. And if there is wiring all the way to the back, that's going to save us a lot of time trying to run wire from the front to the back through, you know, carpet and panels and stuff like that. So we're going to take it off and see what we find. All right, let's get to it. So I guess this video is just basically to show you that speakers like that do exist from Subaru. Or you can, if you've never removed these back panels and never have seen the spots where the speakers go, now you'll be able to see them and know that they are back there. Actually, we've got one that looks like a little mini crowbar. That one works a little better. Oops, where did this come from? And there's one in the middle. Okay. There you go. So, you'll see that your OG door cards have holes. Or it's kind of perforated. So, that is where the speaker would go. I'm going to do some evaluation of these versus those. I may switch one. Because, I mean, they're both pretty ratty looking. But, that is what you will find where the speaker would go. And obviously you would just cut some of that fabric away. So we're gonna set these guys aside. And so you will see there's a hole, mounting hole here. None of y'all wanna be trying to zoom in. Okay, so there's a mounting hole. There's a mounting hole. There's a mounting hole. I don't know. There's mounting holes for your said speakers. So the trick is now to see if there's any wiring that ran up to the speakers. That wiring goes up for the brake light. I, unfortunately, we're gonna have to run the wiring ourselves. That's a bummerooski. So we're gonna have to run the wiring. So I'm gonna take the rest of the panels off back here and we'll go from there. I'm going to obviously connect the rear speakers, which I'm pretty sure the two that are left, this purple and white, to this radio. It's a cheap Chinese $25 radio. And as you can see, they splice it into the existing wiring. They didn't even have the wiring harness, which is whatever, it's fine. I'm gonna run it then down the wire, existing wire loom that goes underneath the carpet. So I'll pull the carpet up, run it over to here, run it up underneath somewhere, probably underneath this to the back. Come down there, run it through one of the little channels in the metal body, and then I'll run it up again up through the carpet, and I think I'm just gonna have the wire come right down here. Yes, it's not gonna look professional. This is in a competition van, but that's totally fine. This van was, it was used. It was very much used. It's got its bad points. So this thing was completely rusty. I painted it and I got carpet from a dude in Hawaii who was parting out a van, so that came out good. But I'm just gonna run the wire right through here. So you're only gonna see, you know, a couple inches of wire. I'm not concerned. As long as we just have some tunes in the back for a full surround sound effect. So I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get to wiring it and start pulling up some carpet.
Yeah. Found cigarettes in your Fendi coat. Even though you don't even smoke. I was changing your access codes. Yeah, I can tell you no one knew. Yeah, you've been acting so conspicuous. You flip it on me, say I did too much. You're moving different when we making love. Baby, tell me ooh, de-la-de-la-da. I wanna know the truth. Ooh, de-la-de-la-da. I know it's someone new. You ain't gotta make it easy. Where you been sleeping? This shit is keeping me up at night. Just a minute. Ooh, de-la-de-la-da.
Okay, we're in business. Hooked up. Let's stereo. Okay, so I'll show you guys kind of what I did. I'm gonna be in fisheye, so if my fingers look long and stringy, I do apologize. So, here is what I did. Worthless flashlight. Let's try this. There we go, that's better. Okay, so I'll point this out. I ran the speaker wire up there above the fuse box, and you can see that wire loom right there in the middle. I'll put another zip tie about right there in the middle somewhere. You can't really see it, but I ran a wire loom with the speaker wire in it just so it matches and doesn't look like there's just some random speaker wire hanging down. Ran that down here through the carpet. Then ran it somewhere here, came over here, which you can kind of feel it, but once you put the floor mat on it, you're not even gonna know. And then I ran it like at some point here, which then came up through here, came down the back, came down here, can't see it, came underneath the carpet here on the other side of the button. There's like a little trough. You can kind of see it there. And continued it up and then came up through here, ran it out through there, and then I ran the other one on the top of this little shelf all the way across up to there. So that is how I ran my wiring. If you're looking to do it more professionally, I recommend not doing that, because you are gonna see that wire right there. Man, you are gonna see that wire right there coming out of the bottom. But I think what you could do is probably pop a hole somewhere around here in the body and then run a grommet and have the speaker wire go through that, and it would look a little bit better. Like I said, I'm gonna put some black wire loom on that, so it just looks like some wire loom coming up through the carpet and then disappearing behind the panels. And that's gonna be totally fine for me in this van, because it's not perfect. I mean, this van is, it's all kinds of hecticness going on here. So, sick. I'm super stoked getting some rear speakers in here finally. I'll kind of show a video, a little something at the end when it's all put together, but that is how I ran my wiring. I think that's gonna work. I've seen guys do it other ways, but their vans are a little nicer, so I think they wanted to be a little more professional. Me, I'm just like, let's get some music in this thing. So yeah, I'm gonna finish buttoning everything back up and then do a little final look at what it looks like. Okay, speakers in, covers on. There's a crack, but you know what? Subaru. So I don't know. Maybe I'll look for some speaker covers eventually, but man, what a difference having back speakers in the van makes. Holy cow. So I cleaned them up with some carpet cleaner, and they came out pretty dang good. I'm super stoked on having back speakers in the van finally. Okay, there it is. Back speakers installed in the Sambar Diaz. Super, super stoked on the speakers. Thank you, Robert from the Sambar squad, for pointing these out in the Yahoo auctions. I'm gonna be paying attention for these again, because it'll be nice to have a backup set. But yeah, not really. I mean, oh yeah, I forgot. So there's the wire loom that I ran up into the
panel, card, whatever. So, I mean, you can't really see it too much. I mean, just there's an inconspicuous little wire coming up. Not a big deal. This van will attract your eyes to other spots that aren't so pretty before you see that, I'm sure. But whatever, worth it. Totally worth it. But yeah, if you want to run speakers, that's one way to do it. And I highly recommend, if you come across some speakers in auction or just wanting to, I mean, essentially you could just use the card, the panel card, whatever, to mount speakers on without a bracket. It might be a little floppy, but you know, you could figure out something like that without having that bracket. But yeah, cool. Not so bad. Take it easy, guys. See you on the next one.